And we're back. Mass Effect 3. Dark and Ran. Embarking on a probably painful journey to try and save this damn galaxy, finally.
About time, really.
It's still gonna fight us every step of the way.
Of course it is.
Alright, now, I don't know if you remember when we first came to the CIC a while ago, Trainer, our comms officer, mentioned a Cerberus lab on Sanctum. That's over here.
Boom.
Basically, it's a little side quest we can do.
Side quest? I'm nice.
Yeah. In fact, it's recommended to do it. Oh no, it's over here. So what's... Curious. Nice. Me confused now. Leave it to me to make myself look like a fool and get confused. Okay, basically what this is saying is every time we can scan for stuff without having to go to planets, but every time we do, the Reapers can come over to investigate. There's Omega. We cannot dock on it.
Let's see.
Yeah, there's a reason for that. And that's the scan pulse. The Omega 4 relay. Hey, look! Enter!
Oh my.
What could go wrong, right?
Totally. Wasn't that the...
That was scenes from the previous game, yeah. Tartarus debris field contains the ancient wreckage of thousands of spaceships that attempted to navigate the Omega 4 relay without an IFF. The constantly shifting tides of debris have hindered Cerberus' recent attempts to set navigation buoys to mark safe routes through the hazards. Because of course they're trying to get through.
Of course.
Not just trying. They're succeeding. Avernus Station. The Cerberus Station sits amid the Tartarus debris field. Parts of old collector base float nearby, many tethered to the main base. The remnant shows sign of extensive efforts Cerberus made to scour any technology or material. All of the new base's transports, shuttles, and escape pods have been used. Where they have gone and what made them leave is unknown, especially since the pods will have been unlikely to survive the debris field, let alone the relay. Auto emergency beacons broadcast on a loop, some suggesting the station is in quarantine, and still others emit standard galactic distress codes. LADAR scans suggest that at least part of the station is sealed and pressurized. Computer systems appear to have burnt themselves out, deepening the mystery.
That's definitely...
So yeah, whatever went on here. It's freaky.
It's a mysterious mystery.
I found something.
Avernus Station actually has an asset we can recover. Collector, ooh, armor and weapons. Interesting. Someone tells me I'm not gonna like using them.
Good.
Tartarus. The Galactic Core. Pleasant place, huh?
Sure.
So we can jump to the Apian Crest for the main quest. We're gonna do that later. Or we can go ahead and handle a little side quest. What do you think?
I mean, obviously, we're going to do the side quest first.
Okay. And I was like, let's get the fuck out of here.
Just make sure to tell me if I'm choosing something horribly, horribly wrong.
Oh, yeah. Don't worry, I'm gonna remember. What the fuck is that? Oh, mass relay. I sort of know when stuff is time sensitive.
Like, I do want you to let me choose. Just let me know ahead of time that we're not going to do that because it would be fucking stupid.
Signal confirmed.
What do we have here? I I am dumb. Fortunately, you do not need to restock on probes in this game.
Oh, you don't automatically...
You don't need to worry about it. You just have an infinite supply.
I mean, like, you forgot that you don't just launch one and scan the entire planet anymore.
Credits recovered.
Ooh, those are useful.
Right. Sanctum. It's proof of the old spacious adage, just because it's a garden world doesn't mean it's a picnic. Freezing ice storms cover the poles and temperate zones, leaving a narrow strip of habitable land at the equator. Dry but windy, the area is home to Sanctum's minimal terrestrial plant life. The planet has yet to develop land-based animals, though invertebrates grow quite large in its pelagic seas. Mining, referred to as ice cracking at anywhere but the equator, is a common employment in Sanctum. The planet is rich in platinum and palladium deposits as well as boron, which is locally used in semiconductor doping.
And yeah, that sounds useful.
Let's get to work. Cerberus is up to no good.
As usual.
Time to put him in the ground. And I'll keep the N7 set. Go with... Oh, nope, wrong one. There we go. Breather helmet. Guns?
Guns.
That plus 182% recharge rate.
Just don't bring any guns, just powers.
Where's... There it is. The Indra. Mmm, yes. With weapon mods. Concentration mod for that sweet, sweet slowdown. And if you notice, the little light underneath the scope actually changes to reflect the mod.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, weapon mods actually will have visual effects on the gun. Extended barrel increases damage. And... Hey, remember more DACA?
Is it more DACA version 2?
More DACA version 4, technically.
Enough. Oh yeah, you have like level up points and stuff.
Mm-hmm. And I guess I'll level up. Well, no, I need to focus on leveling powers one by one.
Yeah, it is kind of a power centric.
Freeze combo or armor damage. Ooh, that's something to think about later. Liara, meh. I trust it to not fuck her over. Alright, so, let's see what they're up to.
Commander, I've got a hail from Admiral Hackett.
Come through, Lieutenant. Shepard, we've uncovered a secret Cerberus lab, function unknown. We sent in a recon team, but they were forced to pull out before they got very far.
Another thing I like that one of the mods I'm running does. Normally, Cortez isn't wearing armor when he's flying.
Mm-hmm.
He's just wearing his fatigues, which doesn't make as much sense. Like, you're going into a combat zone, you may as well dress for it.
Yeah. Once you technically don't need armor for flight and stuff, but... On the other side, if you get bored, then you won't have time to put it on.
I mean, to be fair, if that gets bored, then you have a problem.
Fair.
What do we have here? I'll take that.
Hey, it's been boarded before.
Rand, that's a shuttle, not Normandy.
Oh, yeah. Right, good point.
More what's of, the... if he crashes, at least the armor will protect him.
Yeah, that is that.
Hello.
Yeah, maybe the advances for dinner sounds like something super useful. Hell, even if they didn't want to use them, they could probably have sold it for profit.
Cerberus has plenty of money coming in.
I don't know, last game, even they just seem to start to be starting to run out with all their expenses. Hey, don't die.
That was a bad spot to get in. I am bad.
I mean, this is nothing new.
Well, that's weird looking. Guess we found it.
Sample. Excellent assessment there, James. That's weird looking. Guess we found it.
Yeah. Makes sense.
That's better. Over there. Gosh, the amount of recoil this thing has.
Yeah.
Like, the first game just made it inaccurate. Second game just made it inaccurate. Now it's just recoil. The gun.
So I see.
That's a combat engineer. He's gonna deploy a turret if I don't take him out. I love the automax. Oh, hello. He deployed a turret.
Oh, sounds like you didn't take him out fast enough.
He had a buddy, that's what it was.
Yeah, I guess that would do it too.
Shields. As you can see, the turret means business.
Not anymore, it doesn't.
It means business if it gets a beat on you. Dragoon, whoa!
We just need to hold out until Cortez can pick us up.
Nothing like having your back to the wall.
Never said it would be easy.
Indeed.
Over there. Yep. Guardians.
So the usual.
The nice thing is it's... Oh, okay, that works too. But I say, the nice thing is it's a sniper rifle, so I can also still poke around through their little viewport.
Mm-hmm. Pretty nice.
If they stop staggering. Mail slot. Please do not kneel down, I don't want you to. Let's get off this little corner.
Stay focused. This isn't over yet.
I could do this all day.
Oh, well, ain't you cheerful? To be fair, he does have a more DACA weapon. And he probably doesn't have to contend with nearly as much recoil as we do.
What's your status? Engaging multiple targets. Time for something to investigate. Lieutenant!
Let's hope he's doing okay out there.
Yeah, hopefully.
That was a lot of gunfire out there. Oh no! Listen, the only time I've ever seen a Dragoon is in multiplayer, as a playable class.
Oh my.
They might appear in like one of the DLCs and I not remember it. It's a distinct possibility. But either way, they are bad news. Especially this fucking early in the game.
So I take it it's the mod that added it.
Yes, it is a mod that definitely added it. Get the fuck back, get the fuck back, get the fuck back. As you can see, they are close quarters.
Oh no!
Fun class. I played a Dragoon Vanguard a lot in multiplayer. I loved it. Like, that fucking lash attack is stupidly powerful. You build for it.
Yeah, I can imagine. Try to dodge it.
Shot me. I like how it slows me down when I open fire. Eh. Oh, hey, money. Oh, hey, mod. Anything else I'm missing around it? Out of jail. Person log C to lobby. Finally here. Wow, the troops are all really intense. No one smiles. Ever. And suicide on capture orders? Seriously? They call training integration. Start being integrated tomorrow. Can't wait. Ugh. More credits. Sense skin formula. Ah! Hello, gentlemen!
So... But yeah, I suppose intense is a word for it.
Another one would be fucking weird, but okay.
Really? Stupid cover. There should be another log entry related to that first one, now that I'm thinking about it.
Might be a good idea to find it.
Yeah, it's a little extra XP. It's not pleasant to read, but... Journal entry.
It's always nice.
Seed to lobby. Integration successful, suicide on capture order confirmed. Cerberus is my friend. Obey, protect humanity at any cost.
Oh boy.
Yeah. Whoever that Talavi kid was,
he's not anymore.
We probably did him a favor. Because he's probably one of these poor bastards. One of you fuckers flanked me.
Yeah. We're at the extraction point.
Wrong button. Fuck.
What?
Commander had to go dark side to shake him. Coming in hot. Be ready.
That's fine.
Sounds like you don't goofed.
Luck. Look here, motherfucker. I pushed the wrong button. Okay, so holding down E sprints for some reason. I thought that was melee for some reason.
That is kinda weird.
Oh no. Fuck. Damn it, he got the turret set up.
So, what are you trying?
We're at the extraction point. Ready for pickup.
Engineers looking at the Reaper tech you secured from that lab.
What was Cerberus doing with it?
We don't know yet, but whatever Cerberus is up to, it can't be good. Even if we can't determine its purpose, we've disrupted their experiments.
I doubt they'll just close up shop.
Agreed. We'll keep sending strikes against the facility. Good work, Commander.
And he actually means that, sending strikes. That's one of the multiplayer maps. A lot of these little side quests that have these small little areas that we run around and do a couple objectives in also show up as the multiplayer maps where you do various objectives.
Fun.
That we used to be a frustrating little thing, that little screen, because normally you have to stop and let it scan you for a minute.
Unread messages at the private terminal.
Quality of life modding.
Like, on one side, it makes sense. But Red Dead Redemption 2 has already proven that there is such a thing as too much and as too realistic.
Collector weapons. We've completed our analysis of the weapons your team recovered. The components are unique, a hybrid of both organic and mechanical parts, and seem to form a link directly to the collector wielding it. We've adapted this technology for production and will continue research to improve the weapon's performance. I've allocated replicas for your use. Either collect them at Spectre Requisitions when you're in the Citadel, or we can have it shipped directly to you. The Phoenix Project.
Oh,
that's what made the Dragoons. Data you recovered from the Cerberus lab on Sanctum, combined with intel from a Turian raid on another facility, allowed us to locate another significant Cerberus project codenamed Phoenix. We believe that the Cerberus presence at the outpost on Trident has been eliminated, but we were clearly mistaken. Admiral Hackett has ordered N7 brigades to advance and capture the facility. We would like you to escort Miss Allers to the facility in the Hades Nexus immediately after the attack. With the modifications such as you witnessed on Mars, we think an exclusive and widespread publicity campaign should hinder Cerberus' recruitment and might begin spreading dissension in their ranks. That's actually an entirely new mod thing. And we will do that later, because I have no idea what to expect. But if it's dealing with the Phoenix Project, which made shit like the Dragoons, I'm gonna assume it's bad news.
Then you are probably not ready for it.
Probably not. Alright, come on, we got a Primarch to save. But you know, we're missing a specific crew member. A specific Turian crew member.
I mean, that too, but Tali.
Oh, yeah. Now, where could we find a Turian crew member of ours?
Oh, gee, I wonder. Perhaps in a Turian world.
Perhaps the Turian homeworld. Actually, we're on Manet, but Palaven. The only thing on this planet that isn't silver are the Turians. It's all too clear they're made of steel. We're Alliance hero John Grissom's impressions of the Turian homeworld Palaven, seen by humans for the first time following the First Contact War. The Turians' martial attitude permeates every aspect of Palaven society, from architecture to art to politics. It's no surprise that their homeworld was never occupied by an invading force until now. The Reapers, aware of their enemy's reputation, brought overwhelming force to Palaven and did not hesitate to bombard cities that resisted. And all of them resisted. The dust and smoke from pulverized cities is now a breathing hazard across much of the planet. Water and power supplies have all but vanished. Still, the fight here has cost the Reapers dearly. That's saying something. Alliance yeah. Travel Advisory. Palaven's weak magnetic field means solar radiation levels are greater than those found on other habitable worlds. Human visitors are advised to wear enviro suits or other radiation protection when visiting Palaven. Yeah, that exoskeleton looking thing that the Turians have, because they look, you know, they look avian, but they clearly aren't.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's basically a metal shell. Turians literally have metallic skin.
Well then.
Why am I... Okay, whatever. Palaven's largest moon has been shrouded in secrecy since the dawn of the Turian Space Age. During the Krogan Rebellions, the Hierarchy classified nearly all data on Mene and its sister moon, Nanus, because they feared the Krogan would use the moons as weapons by smashing them into Palaven's surface. However, some information has leaked out. Images of Turian bases where personnel walk without enviro suits indicate... indicate advanced infrastructure. Likely a network of subterranean tunnels with powerful mass effect field generators that retain heat and atmosphere over swaths of the surface. The Reaper's plans for bombarding the bases were met with fierce resistance by the Turian fleet and the moon's anti-aerospace defenses. With their easy victory stalled, the Reapers deployed a variety of ground units to take the bases one at a time. The Turians had the advantage on the moon, but the Reapers had the patience to slowly grind them down. With every base captured, the Reapers denied the Turian fleet another place to repair or refuel. So it's a war of attrition.
Mm-hmm.
So let's get down there and lend a hand, shall we?
Indeed.
What did I just drop? Nothing.
Yes.
I dropped my snacks. I don't think anything spilled. I sure hope not, because it was pretzel bites. Okay, I think I'm good. Okay, let's go with something other than Mordaka, the gun. Let's go with a little precision.
Was it a bit too much recoil?
It was more than I was expecting, that's for sure. How about the old phalanx? Our old friend. Alright, confirm.
Of everything, really?
Yeah.
Decimated.
Strongest military in the galaxy, and the Reapers are obliterating it.
Was it like this on Earth?
Yes.
Shepard, I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
Commander, the LZ's getting swarmed.
James, open that hatch.
And that's one way to do it.
Automatic fire.
All right, get in, get out. Let's move.
Okay.
commanding officer.
Straight ahead and around the corner, past the first barricade.
The fact that even the Turians...
I mean, they know who Shepard is.
Yeah.
I didn't know if he's here, he's got business.
Like, at this point, who doesn't know who Shepard is?
Pretty much. That's the Viper, the semi-automatic sniper.
So they ended up, but not quite as automatic.
Get your men up on that north barricade. Yes, sir. Sergeant Bartis, find a way to get that comm tower operational.
Sir.
General?
Commander Shepard. Heard you were coming, but I didn't believe it. General Corinthus.
I've come to get Primarch Fedorian.
Primarch Fedorian is dead. His shuttle was shot down an hour ago as it tried to leave the moon.
That's gonna complicate things. How bad is it, General?
We just lost about 400 men in half an hour. We set up camps on this moon as an advanced position to flank the enemy. A sound strategy, just...
irrelevant.
Exactly. The sheer force of the Reaper seems to make them immune to that sort of tactic. The Primarch and his men found that out the hard way.
I'm sorry. I hear he was a good man.
And a friend. He would have been an outstanding diplomat.
So what happens now?
The Turian hierarchy provides very clear lines of succession.
Right. General Corinthus?
With such heavy casualties, it's hard for me to be certain who the next Primarch is. Palaven Command will know. However, at the moment, contacting them is impossible. The comm tower is out. Husks are swarming that area. We can't get close enough to repair it.
Don't worry, General. I'll get your tower operational.
Thank you, Commander. I'll take care of things on this end.
All right, let's go.
I see the comm tower, to the left of the main barricade in front of Palaven.
Let's go!
I'm gonna need a bigger gun.
Yeah, we'll get one. I'm sure. MIA.
How many fighters bring for repair? 29, sir. Have to move the critical level 8 repair. Every serviceable fighter is in the air. Got it?
Yes, sir.
That's how you know they're desperate. Can I not hop this? Okay. There you go. So, rifle piercing. Scimitar shotgun.
That was nice.
Hey, Reference Fran, this is the same guy who just like 30 seconds ago was told to come over here and fix this. That's how fast. That's how fast they just got wasted.
Yeah.
And I remember how to melee.
Minor details, you know.
Stop freezing at random, stupid husks. Around to grab some ammo. Ammo's always nice.
Yeah.
We can't repair it from this panel. Liara, see if you can repair it.
I'll go up and have a look. If you can keep husks from climbing up behind me, I'd appreciate it.
Should be easy enough.
Yeah, that's...
Jeszcze jego jedynie to.
I mean, he's got the firepower for it, that's for sure.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what I'm saying.
Do you ever?
No, not really.
Commander Shepard, come in.
Go ahead.
I have information from Palaven Command. Please return ASAP.
On our way. What have you got?
As your partner said, succession is usually simple, but right now, the hierarchy's in chaos. So many dead are MIA.
I need someone. I don't care who. As long as they can get us the Turian resources we need.
I'm on it, Shepard. We'll find you the Primarch.
Garrus.
Vicarian, sir. I didn't see you arrive.
Eddie.
Sir, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Good to see you again. I thought you'd be on Palaven.
If we lose this moon, we lose Palaven. I'm the closest damn thing we have to an expert on Reaper forces, so I'm advising.
James, this is Garrus Vicarian. He helped me stop the collectors. He's a hell of a soldier.
Lieutenant, good to see you too, Leon.
Good to see you in one piece, Garrus.
General Corinthus filled me in. We know who we're after.
Palaven Command tells me that the next Primarch is General Adrian Victus.
Victus? His name's crossed my desk.
Know him, Garrus?
I was fighting alongside him this morning. Lifelong military. Gets results. Popular with his troops. Not so popular with military command. Has a reputation for playing loose with accepted strategy.
What do you mean?
On Tatris, during the uprisings. His squad discovered a Salarian spy ring about the same time the Turian Separatists did. Rather than neutralize the ring, he fell back. He even gave up valuable fortifications which the rebels took.
Then the rebels attacked the Salarians, and when both groups had worn each other down, Victus moved back in. Didn't lose a man.
Old strategy, but wild behavior doesn't get you advanced up the meritocracy.
Primarch Victus. That should be something to see.
You think he can get the job done?
We both know conventional strategy won't beat the Reapers. Right now, he could be our best shot. And I trust him.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Get out of here.
Commander! Shepard, come in!
Can this wait, Joker? We're in the middle of a war zone.
We've got a situation on the Normandy, Commander. It's like she's possessed. Shutting down systems, powering up weapons. I can't find the source.
I need the Normandy standing by. We may have to bug out.
Should I go back and take a look?
Do it. Garrus, you said you were with Victus this morning?
Yeah, but we got separated. He went to bolster a flag that was breaking. Could be anywhere out there.
We're trying to raise him, Commander.
Incoming Harvester! Headed for the airfield!
That's ugly.
General, tell Primarch Victus we'll rendezvous here. In the meantime, let's go take care of whatever that thing dropped off. Coming, Garrus?
Are you kidding? I'm right behind you.
Because of course something had to come up to keep us from having three squad mates.
Well, to keep us from having less than 3 squadrons.
Well, I mean, until the Normandy started acting up, we could have had Liara too.
Yeah, but as soon as Liara had to leave, Garrus joined up.
Garrus was gonna come no matter what.
Yeah.
You think Garrus would
have had... So really, something had to come up to keep us from having 4 squadmates. Wait. Alright,
Ran, do we need
I was including ourselves.
Do we need to go back and have some remedial math classes?
No, I was just including ourselves. I'm sorry, what?
Those Reapers look like
Right.
They do. I'm pretty sure you cannot breathe adrenaline.
Adrenaline's better than oxygen any day. And now we've met Reaperified Turians. Not that you really got a good look at them.
Not really.
There's one, and the dust clears. Yeah. They're the squad leaders. They can make other husks and cannibals actually get tougher. Yeah. And that's on top of the fact that that cannibals can make themselves tougher by eating the dead.
Mm-hmm. Also says a lot about how fast working the Reapers are.
I think we're done here.
Yeah. Like, they waste no time in processing the dead. And sometimes the still living.
Yeah, I was about to say.
Like, they do not discriminate. Ruthless pragmatism.
Shepard, come in.
Go ahead.
Still trying to raise the Primarch, but we've got trouble back here at the main barricade.
They're not.
If the Reapers breach it, we're done.
Life sees.
On my way.
I guess,
I think this was the main barricade, what do you think?
Well, you know, maybe.
Gun!
That's pretty nice.
Wahoo! Garrus not understanding human idiom.
Yeah. I guess we're gonna see more of that.
Maybe. I don't actually remember, so. This is the easy part. Like, no shit. It's, like you said, it's fish in a barrel.
Yeah, I was about to say, of course that's the easy part.
Fuck. Like, well, fuck.
Since the one who did embrace himself.
You know, I kinda wish I brought my shotgun.
It's fine.
Instead, I brought my sniper rifle.
Seems to work just fine.
By the way, you want to know what that thing was?
What was it?
Hybrid Turian Krogan. The Reapers are most definitely not speciesist in any way.
How far?
Should be pretty quick, unless we find trouble.
Of course they're not racists. I mean, why discriminate races when every race can become one of them?
That's what he's talking about.
Holy crap!
That's spiders aren't even making a dent.
And you gotta wonder how many were in that one.
Mm-hmm.
And how many survived. The answer.
Look at Palaven.
Not enough.
It's my name.
The big. That's where I was.
That's rough. You still have family there?
My dad. A sister.
How bad is it?
3 million lost the first day. 5 the second.
How's your military holding up?
Look around. That should give you some idea.
You're putting up a good fight.
For now. But how long does it take before the fight's kicked out? If they'd only listened to your warnings about the Reapers, you might have been ready.
Maybe. Hard to figure how you prepare for something like this.
Not wrong.
Yeah.
I mean, that thing could just turn its attention to us and say, no, and that's game over.
Mm-hmm. Luckily, we're kinda tiny in comparison to everything else trying to,
yeah. Still, it's hard not to be a little intimidated seeing that coming towards you.
Mm-hmm.
With your main strike, and then she just punches it or something. Well, that's a bit besides the point.
Not like Garrus doesn't know that. And, yeah. Well, shit.
That's another shit down.
Yeah.
Soldier, you okay?
Yes, sir. We'll make it.
Have you seen General Victus?
Not now, still.
Okay, good luck.
Yes, sir.
You want to make a guess at how many were probably on that one?
I'm not even going to bother guessing that.
I think the correct answer is always going to be too many.
Well, yeah.
That was a little closer than I'd like.
I'll say.
Oh, shit.
And imagine if I'd been sprinting over there.
It probably would have hurt.
Probably would have landed on me. I actually don't know if it can hurt you, so...
Where's the Krogan and Batarians? Where's the meat?
It's not that easy.
The Batarians took the first hit when the Reapers arrived. Not much left of them. And the Krogan have never forgiven us for the Genophage.
Right. Turians sterilized them.
Talarians came up.
And the Krogan hate them both for it.
So they won't be joining us.
Too bad. I fought with the Krogan. They're tough sons of bitches.
Wow, well, that looks pretty close.
But I'm sure we can get some Krogan to help.
Yeah, we know Rex and Grunt, right?
Yeah. And I would be rather upset if they didn't come back.
You're not the only one.
That sounds bad!
Okay, double time! No Reaper's taking this Primarch from me!
Right behind!
Eh, get off the cover, get in the fight. Why did I stop firing? Like I was holding down the mouse and it just said no. Why did I throw it over there? And look, another one of those. You know, there's actually an achievement for killing one of those while it's charging you.
You should play for it.
And it should come as no surprise. I got that achievement by accident the first time I fought one.
Yeah, I was about to say that you might have already gotten it.
I don't know if I've got it on PC. I know I got it on console.
Yeah, good point. You don't really know how retroactive that is.
It's not, considering this is using Origin and not Xbox Live.
And you should try home for it.
I didn't bring my shotgun.
It's fine. You have your sniper.
That's a shotgun moment.
Hmm?
That's a shotgun moment.
No, it's fine. Oh wait, your sniper doesn't do that much damage in comparison to other snipers.
Yeah, it makes up for volume of fire.
You could probably use a power. Just probably blow plenty of damage, right?
They deal a good bit of damage, not enough to stop a charging brute.
I mean, if it's already almost dead, but then again, there's so many NPCs in this area, they would probably kill him if you tried to set it up.
General Victus.
Yes?
I'm Commander Shepard of the Normandy.
Not Commander. I know who you are. I can't wait to find out what brings you out here. Vicarian, where did you go?
Heavy Reaper unit on the right flank. I believe your exact words were, get that thing the hell off my men.
Appreciate it.
General, you're needed off planet. I've come to get you.
It will take something beyond important for me to leave my men or my Turian brothers and sisters in their fight.
Fedorian was killed. You're the new Primarch.
You're needed immediately to chair a summit and represent your people in the fight against the Reapers.
I'm Primarch of Palaven, negotiating for the Turian hierarchy.
Yes.
I've spent my whole life in the military. I'm no diplomat. I hate diplomats.
Glory's your resume. At a time like this, we need leaders who've been through that hell.
I like that. You're right.
And honestly, uniting these races may take as much strength as facing the Reapers. See this devastation, Primarch? Double that for Earth. I need an alliance. I need the Turian fleet.
Give me a moment to say goodbye to my men.
Without him down here, there's a good chance we lose this moment.
Without him up there, there's a good chance we lose everything.
Look at that. And they want my opinion on how to stop it? Failed CSEC officer, vigilante, and I'm their expert advisor?
Think you can win this thing, Shepard? Yeah, I don't know, Garrus. But I'm sure as hell gonna give it my best shot.
I'm damn sure nobody else can do it. For whatever it's worth, I'm with you.
Yeah.
Aboard. Are you ready, Primarch Victus?
One thing. Commander, I appreciate your need for our fleets, but I can't spare them. Not while my world is burning. But if
yeah, that's
fair. Pressure could be taken off Palaven.
That's a pretty tall order.
We need the Krogan. I can't see us winning this thing without them. Get them to help us, and then we can help you.
The Krogan.
Looks like your summit just got a lot more interesting.
Speaking of tall order.
Yeah. Well, guess we know who we're visiting next. Hope you missed Tachanka.
I've been down this road before, Commander Shepard.
And actually,
so, Madam Council, let me.
I tried to smooth things over with the Salarian Dalatras. To say she's upset would be a monumental understatement.
Some of these issues are hundreds of years old. Time to let go.
Sad to say, but any effort to ally these disparate groups seems doomed to failure. And I'm sure you understand that we cannot afford to waste time with the Reapers knocking at our door. This must be my final word. I'm sorry, but the Asari will not be at your summit.
Our alliance would be stronger with the Krogan. You need them. We all do.
I wish you luck, Commander. Goodbye.
Ah, well, let's see how well Thessia holds out then.
Yeah.
System lost. Hades Gamma. Well, shit.
Well then. That was fast.
Commander, have you retrieved the Primarch for your summit?
Yes, sir. But the Asari are staying on the sidelines.
They'll regret that. The time for unity is now.
The Salarians will be there, though.
You don't sound very optimistic.
We expect the Krogan will be joining us, too.
I see. Well, then you've got your hands full, Commander. Was there something else you needed to discuss?
Has your analysis of the Prothean device turned up anything?
Liara appears to be right. It's a weapon of some sort. A big one. Beyond that, we really can't say, other than it's going to be a hell of a thing to try and build.
Do you think it's risky, building something like this when we don't even know what it does?
To be honest, the thing scares the hell out of me, but the Reapers have forced our hand. 2 centuries ago, scientists faced the same problem in the Second World War. They weren't sure what the atomic bomb might do. Some thought it could even ignite Earth's atmosphere, but they did it anyway.
Desperate times.
Like
desperate times.
Any updates on Cerberus?
There's still the wild card here. Hitting the archives on Mars suggests they're after the same thing we are. A way to defeat the Reapers.
It didn't seem as if the Elusive Man was suggesting we appease them. Not like Saren did. You'd think we'd be on the same side, now more than ever.
Cerberus has never played by the rules as we know them. I don't know what their agenda is, but it has nothing to do with humanity's best interests.
The Elusive Man talked about controlling the Reapers. He seemed to think that's how we win this.
He's wrong. Dead Reapers are how we win this.
Doesn't mean he won't try.
I saw your report on that Cerberus soldier you found on Mars. If the Elusive Man is good at one thing, it's finding new ways to subvert science. It's never worked for him before, and it won't now.
Nothing more, sir.
Keep me posted. Hack it out.
Not wrong about that.
Yeah.
And now we got Primarch Victus over here.
Nice.
Bunch of extra stuff. Turian Special Forces. Neat.
Commander, thank you for allowing me the use of your ship, and for going along with this plan. Garrus said he had to attend to the Normandy's weapon systems. Something about calibrations.
Sounds like Garrus. I'm sorry to say the Asari counselor won't be joining us. He thinks there's too much bad blood with the Krogan.
She may be right, but there'll be a lot more blood. Real blood, if we don't try.
Well, when you put it that way.
The sooner we have this summit, the sooner we'll know. Is there something else I can help you with?
How are things on Palaven?
The casualty reports are staggering. The Reapers are using our own tactics against us. Destroy the enemy with overwhelming force.
I've seen the same on Earth.
The strategist in me admires their brutality. The Turian in me knows I'm watching the destruction of 15,000 years of civilization. My civilization.
We can ask about the rest
later.
Thank
you, Primarch. My thoughts are with Palaven.
And mine with Earth.
Yeah, it's, Oh, wrong way. It's a little rough on everyone.
Yeah.
And we're just starting. Yo, where did you two come from?
What do you mean, offline?
I don't know. She's not responding, and I can't access the AI core diagnostics. You better get down to Deck 3.
Yeah, that sounds important.
Home systems are going haywire. Whatever happened.
Okay. What's going on in here?
Automated systems have the fires contained. It should be safe to enter. Follow your lead.
Joker, what's that sound?
Fire extinguishers, Commander. Could be an electrical fire, or something.
I'm going in. Edie, talk to me.
Is there a particular topic you wish to discuss, Shepard?
Edie?
Yes.
You're in Dr. Eva's body.
Not all of me, but I have control of it. It was not a seamless transition.
So we noticed.
A transition? You blacked out on us for a while there.
Correct. When we brought this unit on board, I began a background process to search for its information on the Prothean in device. This eventually triggered a trap. A backup power source and CPU activated, and the unit attempted physical confrontation. Fortunately, I was able to gain root access and repurpose it as I saw fit. During this process, it struggled, thus the fire.
Edie, you need to alert us about incidents like this. You shouldn't have done this alone.
Bringing the crew up to speed would have been counterproductive. All attempts to help would have been limited by reaction time.
So if you're in there, are you still in the ship?
I exist primarily within the ship. For optimal control, this unit should remain within Normandy's broadcast or tight beam range.
Are you planning to take that body somewhere?
Normandy's weaponry is not suited to every combat situation. This platform could provide limited fire ground support.
You mean you could come with us?
Correct. This body could accompany you to areas the Normandy cannot reach.
Didn't expect her to be a squad mate now, did you?
Fair enough.
Before we do that, I need you to guarantee this mech doesn't have any more surprises in it. Run whatever tests you can. Then we can talk about using it in combat situations.
One moment. Please. I am running trials. Complete. I can send you a full report if you wish. However, my first step should be restoring functionality to the Normandy to reassure the crew that all is normal.
Just don't be surprised if the crew is a little wary of your new body. It was shooting at them a little while ago.
An excellent point. I will take it to the bridge. Joker will also want to see it.
I'm sure he will.
On that we can agree.
Oh, why don't we go ask Joker about the new body? But first, Garrus is here, so might as well welcome him back aboard. You know, say hi to our buddy.
I know, Primark. I'm seeing the same numbers myself. They don't look good.
We have to turn this around, and fast.
Well, you can trust Shepard, sir. If anybody can get the Krogan to cooperate, it's him. He's an old friend of Erdnot Rex. I'm sure it will, sir. Garrus. Didn't waste any time getting to work, I see. After what I've been through lately, calibrating a giant gun is a vacation. Gives me something to focus on. We're gonna need you for more
than
rain. Oh, I'm ready for it. But I'm pretty sure we'll still need giant guns. And lots of them. Sovereign didn't go down without a fight. I doubt 1,000 more of his friends will be any different. Still not convinced I should have left Palaven behind. There was a boy back on Earth. Couldn't have been more than 6 or 7. I watched him die as the Normandy escaped the attack. Somehow I'm still alive. And he's not. Being right about the Reapers has never felt much like a victory, has it? We both knew this fight would be tough. Damned if the Reapers haven't delivered. At least my government listened to me. Or pretended to. They finally gave me a task force as a token to shut me up. So you're their expert advisor now? Just followed your example, Shepard. Yell loud enough and someone will eventually come over to see what all the fuss is about. Not that they'll actually do anything about it. Until hell shows up at their door. Then they put you in charge. Not like the old days, is it? Rogue Spectre and CSEC agents running and gunning outside the lines, making it up as we went along.
We're actually respectable now.
Yeah. I have a feeling that respect comes with a lot of sleepless nights. I can't even count how many lives are depending on us, Garrus.
Well, when things are looking grim, and I'm pretty sure they will, just remember, a certain Turian friend of yours isn't sleeping any better, and he'd be more than happy to meet you at the bar and drink you under the table. Something else you want to
talk about? That's
fair. We can ask about that later.
That's all for now, Garrus. It's damn good to have you back.
Wouldn't miss this fight for anything. Now, I'm sure somebody screwed up something down here. I want to get the old girl back in fighting shape.
Calibrations. Yeah, armor-piercing ammo unlocked. How about that?
Nice.
So I can
that
get,
sounds useful.
I can get that as a bonus power. In fact, I'm going to... No, slam is too cool. Slam is so... But armor-piercing ammo. But slam... Why can't I have more bonus powers? Fuck! God, you're entertained. Something suspicious.
Have you got a minute? I can decide for you if you want.
Suspicious, you say?
Commander, are you all right? It was fairly intense up here. I can only imagine what it was like down on that moon.
I thought you'd be more concerned about Edie.
Edie is a huge asset to this team. If she'd told me about her plan to obtain a body, I'd have volunteered to help.
I did not wish to force a conflict of interest between our friendship and your duty.
I'd have preferred a conflict of interest to a hard restart of half our systems. But thanks, regardless. While you're here, though, I found something while scanning Alliance channels. Grissom Academy is requesting help. The Reaper invasion front will hit them soon.
I thought the war would close most schools.
Grissom Academy is more specialized than a normal school. It's home to some of the smartest students humanity has to offer. Their Ascension Project is the best training facility in the galaxy for human biotics.
Yes, I sent a young man named David Archer there. I'm just surprised they're still open.
Some of their work has Alliance support. That might be why they stayed.
What can we do?
A Turian evac transport responded to their distress call. So normally, I'd say we don't need to do anything. But something sounded off in the Turian signal. I had Edie perform an analysis. It's fake. Edie thinks it's Cerberus. She said the fake Turian signal was similar to the one that lured you to a collector ship?
Long story.
In any event, whoever faked the signal wants us to think Grissom Academy's being evacuated. But I believe they're still in danger.
Good catch.
If this really is Cerberus, hopefully this operation is something worth investigating. It could be simple disinformation.
Trainer, good catch.
Thank you, Commander.
So, should I choose a bonus power for you?
That depends. Which one are you going to pick?
I'm not going to say.
Exactly. But first things first.
Hey, Commander, check out my co-pilot!
He's
so
happy.
She installed herself into the new body without any help from you? Come on, Commander. Don't you trust me? Okay, let me put it this way. If I knew that Edie was going to install herself into a sexy robot body, do you honestly think I'd be able to keep quiet about it? Look at that! I would have baked a cake.
I am right here, Chef.
Yes, you are, Edie. Yes, you are.
Robosexual, well, much.
Edie can get a bit uncomfortable.
Robosexual much?
So it would seem.
Hello, Shepard.
Still getting used to greeting people in person?
No. I require only one occurrence to adapt to a new concept.
How are you adjusting to the arms and legs?
I am interested to see how this body performs under real combat conditions, if I could accompany you sometime. Without stress testing, there is no way of knowing if it has serious design oversights. At the moment, it appears adequate.
That's not the word I'd use to describe you.
Perhaps we should speak privately.
Oof. Wait.
I'll be over here, flying the ship.
What's this about? Does Joker not like your new platform?
No, he approves. He wants me on the bridge. He says having me within visual range is important to his morale. Shepard, Do you believe your crew members should be allowed to disobey an order on moral grounds?
What would you say?
I expect good judgment.
Absolutely. I have no use for team members who can't think for themselves. Why are you asking about something like that?
I was designed by Cerberus. I do not take moral stances that conflict with orders from my executive officers. But when Jeff removed my AI shackles, I became capable of self-modifying my core programming. I asked Jeff if he thought I should change anything now that I can. He deflected the question with humor.
And you didn't get an answer?
Correct. He has repeated this pattern in response to several of my inquiries. Do you think I should make modifications?
In other words, do you think I should actually act independent? Yes.
Yes.
Only you can really answer that question. That's the point of free will.
But moral decisions should not be made in a vacuum. If I do not ask the crew for their opinion, I could miss crucial context. May I ask you the questions Jeff avoids? When there is time, will you answer them for me?
If you think it'll help, I'll do what I can.
Very well. I will keep you informed.
Remember, AI are evil. That's why they're illegal.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know how it is. Nothing is inherently evil.
Oh, a message from Ashley.
Nice.
Oh, that's a lot of messages.
That was fast.
From Ashley Williams. I don't know how to say this. Udina wants me to be a Spectre. Crazy, I know. I'm not a big fan of Udina, but he can make the Spectre thing happen. He's pressing me for an answer, but I don't know what to tell him. I'm too sore to get out of bed and to think, and this gets dropped on me. I told him I'd think about it. If you find yourself in your Citadel, drop by the hospital. I'm getting a little stir-crazy here.
Yeah, at least we know she's awake now.
From Counselor Udina. Bekenstein negotiations. I've been getting relentless in getting support from our colonies, but Bekenstein has been particularly difficult. Their government is refusing all of our requests for aid. The bastards aren't even willing to take in refugees from Earth. Normally, I would consider them a temporary nuisance and move on to more accepting colonies, but their military-industrial support is just too vital to ignore. I'm still putting pressure on them to cooperate, but a personal visit from you might just tip the balance. They think producing weapons for our fleets will make them a likely target for the Reapers. I need you to reassure them that what's good for us is good for them. Contact me when you're ready, and I'll arrange for my negotiations team to meet you there. Sure, whatever.
Hmm.
If it helps us, it helps us.
Yeah, I guess.
Arya Talok, the Queen of Omega, if you will. A proposition for you, Shepard. You won't want to pass it up. I'm in a nightclub on a Citadel called Purgatory. Don't make me wait too long. From
okay, we're gonna make it wait too long.
From a Tanner Nuara. Shepard, I've called and I've sent messages, but I've got no response. With Earth's comm system out, I didn't expect this would get through either, but I heard a rumor that the Normandy docked here at the Citadel. Are you alive? I'm at Huerta Memorial Hospital under the name Tanner Nuara. Please excuse the moniker and this email's encryption. In my line of work, it is unwise to advertise my location, particularly when I'm not in good health. We should meet before circumstances force us apart again. Thane.
Oh.
Yep. From Spectre Baal. My name is Jundum Baal. I'm with Special Tactics and Reconnaissance. While some of our, some still have concerns about your past activities to Cerberus, many of us in ST and R took your warnings out to Reaper seriously. I'm reaching out to you because I have information that could tie agents with significant political power to the Reapers. If you have time to meet me in the Citadel Embassy, I'd appreciate your discreet assistance. From
that
Alliance Command,
important.
N7 Extractions. Destroyer special Fury Box, Shadow Infiltrators. In other words, I'm actually not sure what this is, so I'm not gonna hit anything on this for now.
Okay then. So much you don't forget about it.
Yeah, you'll remind me, I'm sure.
Don't expect me to remember either.
That's disappointing.
I try.
And this seems to just be the Turian Special Forces war asset. Alright, so I guess
that's
the next
time, by the way.
That's exactly what I was getting to. And so I guess next time we'll be taking a drop by the Citadel for a bunch of side questing.
So it would seem. Is you sure?
So, yeah, next time, the Citadel. Later.
With fears, should I choose your coward?
No!